gang. I want to talk turkey today. Actually, I want to talk dog training collars. I'm going to stand back here so you can see me pretty good. And then as I talk about a specific collar, I'm going to get closer. So you won't be able to see my head, and that'll be a little weird, but it'll be fine. So I want to say something to you all. And I have a puppy here who's excited about getting to work with me. So I'm going to encourage her to do a couple of good things. Sit. Good job along the way. So I apologize for some of the distraction, but she knows I've got, it's time for us to train again. And I want to make sure I'm encouraging her to do the right things. So I want to remind you all of something that I've told you all, which is practice does not make perfect.
Girl, that's it.
Perfect practice makes perfect. If your dog is practicing pulling, they will learn how to pull very effectively. That is not our main goal. Our main goal is to teach the dogs to walk on a loose leash. In order to do that, we need to make sure that we are practicing walking on a loose leash. One of the things that I see people make the biggest mistake with,
sit, good girl, sit,
is using the wrong equipment. Incorrect equipment is a biggie. People think, oh, I need a pretty collar. My dog is so cute. Well, that's true, your dog really is cute. And yeah, pretty collars are great. I have this really pretty collar. It's made of leather. It was made by a personal friend of mine. It's hand painted, it's gorgeous. It is not the tool to use when I'm teaching the dog to walk on a loose leash. It hits my dog too low on their neck. Where does it hit them? Right above the shoulders. This is a strength point for a dog. It's also right here on the trachea. So every time my dog pulls against this, every time my dog pulls against this, they are actually hurting their trachea. Let me show you really quick. Right here, it's hitting him right here, the most susceptible spot on his neck. So every time he pulls against this, he's actually possibly doing damage to his neck. These are the collars that you can buy anywhere. Walmart, pet stores, they all sell the great little buckle collar that everybody loves so much. The decorative ones, the cute ones, they're all these kind. They're great for in your house. They're great for when your dog is training. They're not great until then. So do me a favor. Let's try some other options for collars. You certainly can leave this one on while putting on the other one. And since she wants to work with me so badly, I think I'll bring her out. No, yes, I think I'll bring her out. Just trade them out real quick. So you can see what I'm talking about with the next collars. Okay. Good boy. Yeah, you want to work so bad? Fine, good. Alright, so you can see this puppy has got one of those awesome buckle collars that we all love so much because they're so cute. And this one is very cute, just as cute as the puppy. The puppy might be a little cuter because she's pretty cute. So my first favorite, the one that I recommend to almost everybody, is the rolled leather collar. And I will take this off of her and get closer in a minute. Let me get it on her so that you guys can see where I'm putting it. The first time I've had this on her, she's pretty wound up because she just had a nap.
Hold on, baby girl. Where are you going? You're melting like butter.
Okay, so leather because of where I want it to hit. I want it to hit right, wanted to hit right behind her ears. And I want it to stay there. It needs to be tight enough that I can get one or two fingers in, but tight enough that it'll stay up behind her ears, but loose enough that I can get one or two fingers in. And I can get two fingers in because she needs to be comfortable in it. But here's the thing, I need to be able to control this puppy's head, or your puppy's head. You need to be able to control your dog's head. If you want them to walk on a loose leash, then you have to have control of the skull. The problem with the buckle collars is they do not stay where you need them to stay. They don't stay right behind the ears, therefore you lose control of the head. When you lose control of the head, you got problems. So this is actually my favorite arrangement right here. My rolled leather collar right up behind the ears, and then a nice short leather leash for working. Now, when I'm working loose leash walking, and it's going to be a little hard to do that here. Good job! Wow! With a young dog, I want to have cookies, okay? Because I want to reinforce when they do the right thing. It is not about distance, okay? It is not about quantity with young dogs. It is about quality. I am not looking to walk a mile with a young dog. They don't need to be doing that anyway. It's not good for them. It's way too hot right now. It's not good for the dogs to do that. And I want to feed my dog. With loose leash walking, I don't always feed, but if I am going to feed, I want to feed the dog where I want them to be, okay? Which is on my left side. And I always say to people, for chin light, you've got Velcro. And then use your wrist to move the dog around. I also want my dog to be headed in the same direction that I am. They need to be parallel to me. And I've got my cookies in my right pocket. They need to be in my left pocket, by the way. We were working on something else, so I have cookies in my right pocket. Okay, so when I'm working loose leash walking with my dog, I want to teach my dog to give to pressure. Taking and releasing teaches the dogs to do that. Now she's pulling against me a little bit there, not much. But right here she is. I'm going to take and release. Good girl. Till she relaxes and releases. And then we're going to try walking forward again. Awesome. Take and release a little bit. Terrific. Good girl. It does not take much because I'm using the correct equipment. And I'm going to go forward again. Take and release. Oh, I didn't even need to. Okay. Now realize she's got some offered attention foundation work that is helping us as well. Girl, very nice. Good job. Good girl. All right, we'll walk forward again. Take and release. Nice, good girl. Terrific. Now, if she continues to pull, I am going to take and release and back up until she releases. Okay? And I'm going to try to video this outside because inside the house is a lot harder. But you really should start, loose leash walking should start in the house because they need to understand how to give to this take and release. Good girl. And then praise when they do it right. Okay. So that's the rolled leather collar, and I will bring it closer so you guys can see it. Rolled leather collar, and it could be a hair tighter, as it's actually going down her neck and then put back up. But she's a puppy, she'll grow into this quickly for long. As long as it stays up there the majority of the time, I might could tighten hair more. I hate to tighten it too much because then it's uncomfortable and then it makes training uncomfortable. Good girl. But you can see, very effective. I could go out into the yard right now and she's a puller just because she doesn't know. And she would not be pulling me on this collar because of its position on her neck and because I have a nice short leash to go with it and I'm using my take and release. Let's talk a moment about the take and the release. When I talk to and work with people, and some of you guys watching this video have had a little private lesson with me on loose leash walking, I talk about the tug of war. Here's a nice example. There. when we were in elementary school, when you're in elementary school, field day, you are, you probably got to participate in something called the tug of war. You have team A and team B. And as long as both teams are pulling on the rope, the tug of war game continues. But what happens when one side lets go? Well, the tug of war ends. One side falls, and that's they call the winner. When I think of loose leash walking, or I think of the problem that most people have, is think of that tug of war game. I think of the dog being team A and the human being team B. Dogs don't know what they're supposed to be doing. So what do they want? They want to go somewhere. Best way to do it is just to go, because that's the way they think. So they start walking, and we're on the other end of the leash, and we're pulling. And pretty soon the dog continues to pull, and we continue to pull, and we have a great game of tug of war. Not very effective for loose leash walking, however. Okay, leave it. Good. Good girl. So your dog is not going to let go of the rope. That's going to be your job. That's, you're the more intelligent species here. And the take and release allows you to do that. The reason I do the take and the release is for the release, not for the take. Because the release allows me to, good girl, lots of, make sure you follow it with praise. It allows me to do a mini let go of the rope. If one side of the team never put steady pressure on that leash, I mean on that rope in tug of war, they'd never have a tug of war game because there'd be nothing to tug against. That's the same with your dogs. You want to be the one who never allows steady pressure to happen. And when they're standing and being good, good job, it is your job to let go. I see so many people, so many owners, one of the big things that they do, and they get all worried and they get all ready, and oh my gosh, my dog is gonna pull, and pretty soon, who's pulling here? Not this puppy. She's not pulling. Let go. Don't let go of your leash. Let go of the pressure. Say to yourself, am I pulling or is the dog pulling? If this is you, you're the problem, not the dog. Release. She doesn't like that, does she? No, I know, I don't blame you. I wouldn't want to be pulled on either, really. For no reason. So that is important. You must always be the more intelligent species here and not pull, okay? Release, release if they release. Take and release if they pull so that you don't give them anything to pull against. All right, so what if she does that? You have a couple of options, okay? You could say something to her. You could go over and take a hold of her collar. You could surprise her and just bop her on the butt, which is what I did, and make a game of it. Oh, goodness. That's where your leave it comes in. Leave it. Good, leave it. Wow. That's where your leave it comes in, and that's a completely different skill that we combine with our loose leash walking. Like it. Leave it. Quiet. Good boy. That's a completely different skill that we teach our dogs that will help with loose leash walking. Oh my goodness. Okay. So again, she's trying to pull. I take and release. Then I release. See what she does? Take and release. Good girl. Excellent. Nice work. I want to feed her again where I want her to be. Occasional cookie someplace else is okay. But I want her to learn that this is the right place to be. That is the best place to be because she gets to walk nicely right there. Good job. Nice work. Nice work. So a little tickle on the hind end. Some dogs can even take hold of their tail for a second and get their attention so that they're no longer pulling on you. The idea is quality, not quantity. I want to get a small distance with no pull. If I can't accomplish this in the house, I have no business taking this on the road. So you might think to yourself, well, Elaine, I gotta come to class, so how's that gonna work? I gotta come to class, and coming to class means that my dog ends up pulling me.